We begin with breaking news. King 5 has obtained exclusive video of the crane that collapsed in South Lake Union yesterday afternoon.
That's right. Two iron workers and two drivers were killed, including a Seattle Pacific University student. King 5's Susanna Frame joins us now with a look at that video. Susanna.
We got this just, I'd say, about an hour or so ago. You know, this is the real thing. It's hard to watch, but we're going to take a look at it. This is what was taken from a dash camera on someone's car in the area at 3:30 yesterday.
Scott Gaines was making his way to work, coming off of I-5 on the Mercer exit. He is quick to notice on his right the first movements of the crane about to collapse. You can hear it in his voice. Gaines knows this is serious.
No.
The main portion of the crane, what's called the fixed tower, starts coming down. You can see it hit the Google building over Mercer. Then the top of the tower, what I believe is called the slewing ring, separates. And then the two separate pieces are headed onto Mercer and the cars below.
Oof. Yeah, so you can see that we slow-mo'd the video and we stopped it before because we want to be as absolutely sensitive as possible mm-hmm. to the families because we know that four people lost their lives right. in that second. I think we could maybe just show it one more time. This is, I'm sure, a piece of videotape that the investigative team will be looking at. Mm-hmm. You know, I'm not an expert, but there might be something on that tape that shows or provides some clues.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it was interesting. I was wanting to see this video just because we had so many witnesses in the area saying that there was wind that blew through or a strong gust of wind at that moment, but it's looking like from this video we really can't get an indication of that because there are so many buildings. You don't see flags or anything like that. Is that how you see it as well?
Yeah, I mean, you'd have to have, I think, a better angle where you could see the actual, what the main structure called the fixed tower
right.
In its entirety right before. But it's just so sad to see that coming down. And I think that the young man that took the video, who was on his way to work, Scott Gaines, you could hear in his voice really shaken up. And he contacted us today and said, you know, is this something that you think would be in the public interest? And we think it is because
Absolutely.
This is what happened. Mm-hmm. And it's just a horrible, horrible shame. But hopefully this kind of tape can be used for a better purpose.
Yeah. Especially with an investigation, because you can get a sense of exactly how big that crane was.
Oh my gosh, yeah, and just the impact. And there was a lot of people.
Yeah.
You see, there's so many cars in the area.
It's a busy
area. And a lot
area.
Of people have those dash cams now, and you know, who in a million years thought that's what he was going to see on that day.
Mm-hmm. In the midst of, as we're all dealing with the sadness and the shock from this, I know you being part of the investigative team, I know you have you know, a lot of things you're always working on. What questions will you be pursuing in the coming days?
I guess the big question is, you know, what happened and how can we make sure we prevent this from happening again? Mm-hmm. So we're working on that tonight and coming up tonight at 10 and 11, okay. we'll have our very latest on that.
Okay. All right, Susanna.
Thank you, Susanna.
We'll see you then.